So I take it as a mark of enthusiasm if you didn't get up and dance or even clap very much. But, I mean, at the same time, I would feel insulted if you talked a lot to each other, especially, I really like this one, but I prefer the album version. So. It's demoralising. It's like when you go to people's houses and they put a record on, so you're going to write some real neat about the side of the first, and they talk all over it. You know? Why? You must just make, you know, have a bass drum track and two people nattering in the background. So, you know, that's what it's all about, and we're going to be playing this stuff. I used to see things all the time, actually.
Thank you.
about two happy young people and their descent into the inferno known as marriage. Guys like us would do when we get together. We sit down and we look at the film because we like to sit down. And I'd like you all to imagine that as you're sitting down, this is a film of some kind. And imagine that you're looking at it not in horribly clear, precise 35mm where you can see all the nasty little veins on our faces, but good old grainy Super 8. Just imagine this is a holiday movie from your youth, or your middle age, or your senescence, or your decline into the inevitable coffin that awaits. And where do we go from there? Either we go to one of those special little holes in the ground, or we're just burned, aren't we? But do you know what actually gets back to your relatives afterwards? I mean, sometimes it could actually just be a piece of, you know, Kentucky Fried Chicken and a load of potash. You don't know what you're actually burying up. So don't be reverential about ash. So this next song is called Ash.
Yeah. Just a rule is free.
books. There's very little, there's only one, something like one chromosome difference between 999 million and 1 billion between us and a wardrobe. There's just one very, very fractional difference in chromosomes, which is why every so often you have a wardrobe as a conventional baby. Which is disappointing if you prepared already one wardrobe for your offspring to arrive, and this is what happened to this boy Rosemary, because he narrowly misses being a wardrobe, and so he has this feeling that he should have things that come out of his chest full of socks all the time. He experiments with, you know, conventional transvestite modes and all this, but he finds it unsatisfying. One day his parents come in and he's furiously pumping a pair of tights into his navel, which is really tough. He's quite young. So they take him to a tree surgeon who suggests that, they say, well, he says, well, how old is your boy? And the parent, Mr. and Mrs. Boyd, said, saying in unison, ah, gee, we don't know, he's only a child. Well, the simple thing, the age of tree is determined by the wings going inwards, yeah. Will you move section of leg? And then Mr. and Mrs. Boyd said, ah, oh, gee, he's only a kid, he don't want to move a section of his leg. And the doctor says, there's no problem, I'm inexpensive. So suddenly, Mr. Boyd, in a rare flash of machismo never before or since repeated, saws the doctor's head off with a chainsaw. And they find out that the doctor actually has a chromosome deficiency which causes him to turn into a wardrobe every time there's a lunar eclipse. Just then, their boy Kevin becomes a footballer and they all live happily ever after, except that Kevin turns into a raging homosexual. He isn't Kevin. What's wrong with that? Oh, I've done that one already.
Capistrano.
from your heavy death sleeping tank.
Yeah.
let's start this one. We're not going to play either of those, so that's all right. You can relax.
Thank you.
offer you some meat in exchange for a good loaf of grass. I'll smear it on you and on all your apples too, if I thought it would help you relax. The bones in the ground, well, they never make a sound, and the bones in the ground.
Thank you. Are you ready to go to bed? We got like a whole mess of shit for you guys because you've been so far out. I don't say that to just every town we go through because we play a lot of town. You people are all there, man. Wish I could say the same for us.
So Thank you.
Morris and Peter. See you later.